Robin, you okay? I'm gonna call for help. I'll stay there. Yes, I need an ambulance to the Elm Street Pier. My wife fell in the water. I revived her. She's breathing shallow. She's got mild hyperthermia. She's hypoxic. Hurry. Hey. Okay.
Where's Emma?
Emma's in her room. Are you sure? Okay, just go double check. Okay, okay. Thank you. Okay, thank you, Mercedes. Hey, Emma's in her room and she's fine, okay? She's fine.
Not that, okay. Emma.
Robin, what are you talking about?
Yeah, little girl, she was here. Emma, where did she go?
No, hey, Robin, hey, stay with me, hey. Stay awake. Hey, stay awake. Come on. Okay, Evans is here. Evans is here. Stay awake. She's over here, hey! Come on. She's conscious, speech unimpaired. When I found her in the water, she was just floating there. I got her up, I revived her. I don't know how long she was in there, though. Okay.
How'd she get in the water?
I don't know. It's okay.
Just so you know, a cup of coffee does not qualify as a real date.
Okay, that's about as real as you're gonna get.
Really? You sure you don't wanna just get wild and crazy?
No.
And we'll go have an entire meal together sometime, say at that Italian place. But we're out now, you know, get a nice bottle of wine.
That actually sounds really romantic, but I'm pretty sure you and your mirror would have a better time.
Take her to OR2, I paid Dr. Kim to bring in the warming aid.
Wait, what happened?
Robin fell in the water off the pier. She was unconscious when I got her out, but I got her breathing.
She should be okay.
I don't know.
Oh my God, I can't believe this. Everything Robin's been through, and now she accidentally falls off the pier?
Or she tried to commit suicide.
Hey, guys. I'll stay with her till Dr. Kim comes back. Thanks.
Hey.
Are still cold? How you feeling?
Shaky. Exhausted. Thanks for pulling me out of the water.
Thank God I saw you.
I feel so stupid. I'm so embarrassed.
For what?
I've been going to that pier my entire life. I should have known better than to stand so close to the edge.
Robin, why were you there?
I just needed time to think.
About your appointment with Dr. Brown? You know, you were supposed to meet me after you didn't answer my calls.
I needed a little bit of time, okay?
I love you and I'm so glad that you're safe, but Robin, I can't help but wonder.
What?
Did you really fall into the water? On accident, or did you jump in on purpose?
Robin has postpartum depression. There's a lot of stuff going on in her life right now. It's very overwhelming, not to mention all the sleep she's been losing. And everyone expects her to be all sunshine and roses because she's a new mom, and she feels horrible that she's not.
That is what I'm saying. That depression that she is feeling.
No, Robin would never try to kill herself. She cares too much about the people who love her, and she wouldn't do that after Georgie's death. She has respect for life.
The postpartum depression that women feel, yes, almost never do they want to commit suicide.
You don't know her.
She could be the exception, Maxie. Look, I've done the research.
I don't care what you say. My cousin is not some case study in a medical report.
Of course she's not. That's not what I'm saying.
I'm not gonna stand here and listen to your sweeping judgments about who Robin is and how she feels. You don't have a clue.
Okay, do you want to help your cousin? Then it's time that you start looking at the cold, hard facts.
You're wrong.
And what if you're wrong? And Robin does succeed next time she tries to kill herself.
The water is freezing this time of year. Why would you think I would jump in?
I'm just trying to find some sort of explanation. I mean, you've been overwhelmed and depressed.
Yeah, so I left my life and I, you know, took a drive to Rochester, but that doesn't mean I want to kill myself.
Well, you have admitted to suffering from postpartum depression.
And I've started therapy, and I'm on my road to recovery.
Okay, well, speaking of therapy, how did your session go?
All right. I mean, it's kind of strange to be with a complete stranger and immediately dive into, you know, details about my personal life, but I'm sure it'll get easier as time goes on.
Can I ask you why you didn't come and meet me, or why you didn't return any of my calls?
I needed time to assimilate the information.
Okay, well, your session was over hours ago, so where did you go?
What is this, the third degree?
Robin, obviously I've been very worried about you, and I love you. You and Emma are my life. You mean everything to me, so I'm sorry if I'm pressuring you. Okay, I'm trying to figure out what's happening.
Okay. I went to the pier to think. Carly was there. And we talked for a bit, and you know how she's not my favorite person.
And she just stayed on the pier?
No, I went to see Sonny.
Okay.
I've known Sonny for a very long time. He knows me really well, and sometimes he feels like a safe haven to me.
Did it help?
Yeah. He always does. Anyway, so I went back to the pier. And I was so tired. I should have just gone home, but I was standing there, the fog rolled in, and I was looking out at the harbor, and I don't know. I guess I just got lost in thought, because the next thing I know, I slipped and fell in, and...
Yeah, I went looking for you. I almost walked right by you, but then I saw something that was yours.
What?
A ripped up prescription.
Yeah, Dr. Brown thinks that I should take antidepressants.
So why did you rip it up?
Because I've done research on other non-drug therapies, you know, hormone therapy, diet and exercise.
And what did Dr. Brown think of all that?
Well, Dr. Brown doesn't think I have any time to waste. She thinks I should start taking the pills right away.
Robin, I know you've been under enormous stress. Are you sure you didn't give in to a bad impulse out on the pier?
Patrick, I didn't try to kill myself, okay? I need you to believe that.